So you've got the interview, you've got the job, you're going to start working. You need to do your job well. And that's the first rule. And I know it sounds like, well, it's obvious, but you're being paid because they've recognized that you are qualified. They've recognized that you are knowledgeable and competent. Therefore, when you start working, you need to demonstrate all those things that they haven't just made a mistake, basically. You need to do your job well. And I would even say you need to do your job very well. Okay, so first rules, do your job, do your bit well. Second rule, I think you've said it here, enthusiasm, show energy. So the posture at work will be really important. The way you walk in at work will be important. You do not shuffle your feet. You've got a spring in your feet, in the way you work. You smile at people. You're not the grumpy one because you have to display energy. You're always ready to help, basically. And you know, if your colleagues are not like that, because they've been here for a long time, and or there's a new kid on the block, yeah, always full of enthusiasm. Oh, you're a breath of fresh air. You want to keep being that breath of fresh air for as long as you can. So, do your job well, okay? Show energy at work. Don't be the one who arrives late because you slept in. What does that say? God, I didn't even have the energy to get up to work today. Don't go, good morning, God, we're here again. No. That's for people who've been here for several years that are now fed up of working. You're new. You need to show enthusiasm. You need to show energy. So something you've all said, positive attitude. Positive attitude, it's about being positive about your work. God, I hate working here. Oh, the conditions are terrible. Well, go and look for another job if you're not happy. There's no other job. Well, if there's no other job, you just make the most of what you've got and you're positive. And you do not participate to gossip. Because then you become the gossiping person. The one who likes to tell stories about the others. And if you don't get that attitude now as you are restarting on your work journey, then you'll just start deflated right from the start. The next bit that nobody said is about showing ambition. And showing ambition is about accepting to go on training courses, wanting to do more, wanting to be more than what you are just now. And showing ambition is about when you're sent to a training course and you go, why am I sent there? What am I going to learn? I know it already. It doesn't matter. They're sending you on a training course. It's they're investing in your future. No, they're not sending you on, well, they hope you're going to stay with them, but it's that every company knows, every organization knows that the moment they develop their staff, there's a risk that the staff will go and work for somebody else. Such is life. But they're investing in you, they're investing in your future, so don't go, no, actually, I don't think I will bother with that one. Thank you very much, because we've already seen that when I was at training there. You just say, yes, okay, you never know who you're going to meet at this training course. And you're bound to learn something, even if it's a little thing. And you're out of work for some time. So that's just another bonus, if you've had enough for a while. I'm going on a training course. But make sure that you learn at this training course. Okay, and then the last one that nobody said, it's show respect. So how are we going to show respect? Politeness, very important. Politeness.
Manners.
Manners. That's at the, yes. I never think you know it all because you won't. So manners is about being polite. So good morning and thank you. You will be amazed at how many people do not even look at you in the morning when you come to work. They don't even say good morning. If you're first in the office, you have to say good morning to people because they will say good morning to you. And if you don't answer because you've already at work for 15, 20 minutes, half an hour, you go, hi, good morning, as in happy to be here. Never mind the problem you've got at home. Never mind the problems they've got at home that they're bringing to work. You're going to rely a lot on people to show you the way in the organization. Thank you is a word you're going to learn by heart. So thank them in person, thank them by an email, thank them just to show that you are grateful. Because then they'll go, oh well, you know, it's like getting thank you cards at Christmas. And you go, oh, that's really good. You don't send any, but oh, that's really good to receive. You feel better by giving, so that person will feel better and will have more confidence. Oh, I can help them again because they were grateful for my help. Punctuality is part of showing respect. If you're told to come at a meeting at 9 o'clock, you have to be there at 9 o'clock. And again, the way you dress will show that you respect them. So, to summarize, be positive, be happy to be there, okay? Do your bit well. You've been employed to do whatever work it is, so you do it well. You show ambition, that means you go on your training courses, you go and meet people when it needs to be meet people, when you need to volunteer, when a job needs to be done and you just happen to have some time, you go and do it. You never know who you're going to meet, okay? And you increase your network in the organization. Do your job well, do energy at work, and respect the other. I think of and commitment to the organization. Those are the 5 things. And remember all the things we've said at the interview, which just work the same, because especially at work, people will have an idea of who you are. They will have asked questions, and they've got an idea who you are already. And then it's for you to say, you've made the right decision, you've employed me and not them, you've employed me, I'm going to be positive, I'm going to offer my service user the best experience they can have, bearing in mind their circumstances and where they are. And you're just going to assert yourself in the workplace, and by what you're going to do, you're going to move on and move on and move on. And it's either you want to be here and stay here all your life, and there is no problem with that. But if you want to move up the way, it's even more important. Or if you want to move on into another organization, same job, better money, then it's even more important.